are at an inflection point for human creativity. These happen every so often in our history, usually caused by some sort of technology innovation. The innovation this time is artificial intelligence, or generative AI, and it's going to change the way we tell stories. I know this personally because it already changed me. In the last 6 months, I have made over 2,000 images and videos from AI. I was not a creator before this. Perhaps I'm a little addicted to it. My family wonders sometimes when I share with them the next image, you know, I kind of think they want to see the next one, but along the way, I learned a lot about how to make things with AI tools, and also a little bit about what it might mean for creativity. We have such strong imaginations when we are young. When I was a child, I loved to read. I loved when my parents read to me. I loved playing with Legos, all the good stuff. And I remember when my parents brought home a home computer, 16 color graphics. I was in heaven, and I could play this game where I was Gandalf, the wizard. Later in my life, I never really learned to paint, and video photography was a little bit too expensive for me to do, so I didn't become a creator. But I think there was something inside me during that time. And I think it's inside all of us. I think it's been there since the beginning. Humanity has been telling stories for 100,000 years, and about 70,000 years ago, we learned how to record them. Cave paintings. Eons later, we invented the printing press, learned how to distribute these ideas. That was one of the inflection points. The camera allowed us to record ideas instantly. And then broadcast technology, one to many became one to millions. The next big inflection point has been recent. That was mobile and the internet, where all of us, it democratized creativity. It democratized us as creators. We were able to use our camera phones and capture photos, capture videos, and share them with everybody. And we did. Trillions of photos, trillions of videos have been created, more media than ever in the history of our species. The next inflection point is now. By the way, it can be scary. Hopefully, after the end of this presentation, you'll see that it also can be uplifting. Generative AI takes the camera out of the picture and allows you to start with an idea that you put into text and create a text prompt into an AI engine. And that comes back with a term paper or a tweet thread or programming code, or now, images and video. Image creation has really rapidly and radically advanced in the last 6 months. So about 6 months ago, if you would have made something, maybe it had an extra finger or an extra arm or something. And now it's becoming more photorealistic. The way the technology works is fascinating. A diffusion model, which is a machine learning model, will start with a latent space, which is essentially the image, but use random. It makes random noise there. It starts with a single point, randomly each time, and builds out mathematically, based on your prompt as a guide, along with the training data, to generate an image in seconds. Each time that you regenerate, it will start with a different point, a different seed. And that is why our images look different every time we create something with AI. And that's why it's not copying. It's generating something new. So the technology is the most advanced technology we've ever seen as humans. But it's actually pretty easy to use. Let's do a text prompt together and see what happens. So there are some building blocks that a good text prompt for imaging will have. Specifically, first, a medium. It's like a photograph or a painting. Second, a subject, a man talking, an action on a setting, a TED stage. And then finally, the style. So this would be the creative direction. These words here represent sort of photorealism. So let's see what happens. Normally, this would take about 15 to 20 seconds. And here we are, a TED guy on a stage talking. So pretty cool, but it's really fast. So let's iterate a bit and have fun. Let's put our favorite Gandalf into the image and see what happens. So let's get, oh, by the way, let's give him some grotesque clothing as well, just to see what that looks like. So here we go. And here's Gandalf, kind of, right? He's a little funky, I like him. But he is on a TED stage, so that's pretty cool. Let's do one more thing with Gandalf. Let's give him some special effects behind him, he's a cool guy. And let's use different styles. So this style would be of 80s sci-fi illustration and see what happens. Okay, now that's a wizard, right? Okay, he's pretty good. Now you might be an artist and you might say, I could make that. I couldn't make that. And if I could, or if you could, it would take you days because of the detail in this image. It took us seconds. Not every prompt has to be elaborate to be powerful. This is a prompt study that was done by user researcher Lily Godbo. And she took this prompt of a girl and just incrementally aged her, just changing the age in each prompt to see what would happen. 5 years old, gradually getting older, 15 years old, a 20-year-old woman, a 30-year-old woman, a 40-year-old woman, a 50-year-old woman, and a 60-year-old woman. So the prompt study quickly for me moved from a prompt study to a study on aging and a study on bias, on how the training data perceives 40 years old. Also notice the fact that the word woman defaulted to Caucasian. So there is likely a whole TED talk on bias in training data and bias on engine. But it does show you that by just changing the words a little bit, you can get a very different outcome. So as I did more creations, that addiction I have, there's some hacks I learned. This is a little one I'll share with you. Take an iconic photo or just a cool photo that you like, and you can put it in an AI engine and use the describe function. This Elvis picture that's iconic of Elvis on stage, this is what the engine thinks the prompt would be to create that. These are four prompts that it comes back with. Now, if you do a close reading of some of the words up there, you'll notice that the syntax is not syntax that any of us would create to make this image. Piles slash stacks. I do not see those in this image. I wouldn't come up with that myself to come up with a prompt to make that. Love core. I'm not sure that's a real word. So AI is creating where it's actually the style, it's in the engine, the style's love core. But the point is, it's not a word that a person would ever come up with to describe this image. My favorite on there is kombucha punk. Seriously. Well, it's awesome. I was like, this is cool. I can work with this. So I said, look, if our goal is to get the coolest image to come out of AI, let's like work with the AI engines and give it what it wants. Let's give it back these sort of phrases. So let's try one right now. Let's take post-70s ego generation, which is a style that came up a lot with some of the describes I did. Turns out that's actually an artistic movement of Chinese artists. Notice the images are all Caucasian again. So again, not to make this the bias talk, but it's interesting. Let's combine that post, but they're cool. Let's combine that post-70s ego generation with one of those funny words that we saw. This was one of the funniest that I ever found in the 6 months. Mommy's on the phone core. I literally do not know what that means, but I was like, I gotta see what it makes. So let's mash the two together. Post-70s ego generation and mommy's on the phone car and see what happens. Boom, there you go. So got the 70s vibe, a Caucasian woman again. And the telephones are not something mommy's gonna wanna spend too much time on, but her hair's looking great today and she's feeling good about that. So you can kind of have fun with these, as you can tell. These are your Legos. Put in some kombucha bunk next time. Put in brooding mood, see what happens. Video is next. So 6 months ago, this was the first video I made with a prompt. And you can see how it's warpy, and its video is rapidly and radically advancing as well. In fact, this week, OpenAI announced some amazing things with video. I'm guessing that this talk is going to be out of date very quickly, given how fast AI is moving. But I think the point is that it's moving forward. Realism is coming to video, a wide range of styles, and our ability to tell stories in seconds with a prompt, with an idea, is coming, is now. And I think what's going to happen with this innovation, again, I hope in 2 years it's a lot more, that those dance videos that we're all seeing on TikTok that we're sharing right now, the performances are going to become more videos of ideas, more videos of creation. So the next thing you can try, if you'd like, is music. So there's this music engine that you can put a prompt in, a text prompt again. It will create a music bed, it will create lyrics, and it'll have someone sing it, all artificial, in seconds. So let's put our favorite post-70s ego generation, Mommy on the Phone Core, prompt into this track and see what happens. Mommy's sitting on the couch, going through her phone. She's always in her own world, never wants to let go. Snapchat, Instagram, and Facebook. So she's gotta get that perfect angle for the likes, it's true. Mommy's on the phone, she's always on the phone. Can't never get her attention, she's always in the zone. So, that song. That song. That's not a good song. I mean, but it was, I like, honestly, it was going through my head and I had to practice, and it's like, I can't get the song out of my head. What's weird about that song, though, is that that little Mommy on the Phone Core created a whole story about a child trying to get the attention of the mom who's addicted to social media. I mean, like, so this stuff is amazing and it's fun and it's uplifting when you get to use it a little bit. Okay, so storytelling is the next big thing, and this is a masterpiece. It's a painting by Hieronymus Bosch, The Garden of Earthly Delights. You're probably familiar with it. There's a lot going on in this painting, and I said, well, what happens if we could ask the AI to kind of give us more of the story, kind of get in there and tell us what's going on? So I asked for an extreme close-up of this painting, and this is what it came back with. These are not close-ups. These are not blown up pictures. These were generated. This is what the AI thought would be happening in that painting. So that, to me, was fascinating. It was sort of like fan fiction for art geeks, you know. And so where researchers and everyone are going now is this notion of character consistency, this idea that to tell stories, we need to have the character not warp on you by the end of the video. With celebrities, this is a lot easier because they're embedded in the training data. But for you and I, it's a little harder, but that's changing. Now we can be part of these stories too. This is me. Not me now. This is me from college because I'm not stupid. I used a good photo from then, right? And I never played football. So this is me from college with a weird prompt where I'm playing football with these uniforms that never would be on the football field. This is me in a 19th century painting. This is me in a movie. This is me in a music video. As you can tell, I had way too much fun with all of these places to put my favorite character, myself, in things. And so it's really interesting to think about where this is going. This is me asking the engine, what do I look like older, as a video. In 18 to 24 months, I believe that we're going to be able to make videos of ourselves and what if our lives and all sorts of things. AI has been trained, as we just discussed, on hundreds of millions of images, more than any one of us can see in our entire lifetimes. But each of us has a brain, the original AGI, and we've been trained on our lives, deeply, for a long time. I believe there's an opportunity for us to take the influence that we have, the influences, and the influence that AI has, and combine them to create new things, new ways to create, new ideas, new artistic direction. And it's certainly the right time. AI is hitting an inflection point. The early adopters are now moving into mainstream. There's 7 billion smartphones, billions of computers. Everyone's going to have access to this technology. We are at an inflection point for human creativity. The aha moment that I had, I can be a creator. Maybe you're having one now too. You can be a creator. Maybe you will be the next Scorsese. Maybe you'll be the next Mozart. Maybe the next Picasso. I think we can all create new things together, and I can't wait to see what you create. Thank you.